Hey, welcome to Adobe's Think Tank. We're going to get through this interview pretty quickly because I want to get back to watching Wild Wild Country in the hotel room. But with me is Jake Porway, founder and executive director of DataKind. And it's kind of the easiest question in the world to ask first, but I kind of wanted to talk to you about data for good and just, you know, using data for the best of intentions.
Mm-hmm. What does that mean?
What does that mean, right?
Yeah, exactly.
That was like kind of a question, but not a full question. That was me going like, hey, let's just throw some stuff.
Yeah, sure. No worries. Are you testing right now or are we going?
Oh, we're totally going.
Oh, great. Just
totally
making sure. That was like, oh, should I give a test answer? Oh, great.
It's
I can
so
riff
comfortable
on that.
That we can just rip off.
Yeah. I know. Make it so comfy. So, you know, we talk at DataKind a lot about doing data for good and using AI in the service of humanity. And the thing is, we say the best of intentions because so many people out there are realizing they can give their skills back. There's opportunities to help nonprofits and governments use data to predict where famines are going to occur or get clean water to people more safely. But it's actually tricky to do. You know, sometimes we try our best. We get out there and say, we're going to volunteer some time out there. But doing it right can actually take a lot of work and a lot more practice than you might expect. So we're always trying to help people do it better, whether it's with DataKind or in their own companies.
Yeah, and talk to me like maybe through a sample thing or just kind of that process of how do you make that more efficient? How do you make that effective? Because again, you probably don't know the unintended consequences of trying to get into a space, but you know, what does that look like?
Yeah, so the way that we work, DataKind, I should say, we're a volunteer organization. We get data scientists to go team up with nonprofits to help solve their data science and machine learning challenges. And so actually, you know, a lot of people think, great, just, you know, give me a project, let's just jump in. But like you said, we don't always know the right thing to build. We don't know how it's going to be used. And importantly, with this whole conversation about ethics in the AI space, we want to make sure that we're thinking really critically about how we're building algorithms that don't cause harm. So what we'll often do is we have a pretty long kind of get-to-know-you process, a scoping process, where we'll bring in NGOs that say we think we could use machine learning or AI, and then data scientists sit down and sort of listen to their challenges, knock on some data, see what we could actually build. And I'll actually say that's probably one of the most enriching parts for both sides, because a lot of nonprofits come in and say, you know, my AI need is I need a new database, because that's like sort of what they know, right? Just like a corporate client might say, I think I need Hadoop. But instead, good data scientists may step them back and say, well, what are the challenges you're trying to solve? You know, we talked to one group that was trying to prevent fires that were occurring. You know, Red Cross was saying, we want to stop fires from happening where they could be preventable. So, you know, data scientists step back and said, well, how do you do that? And they said, well, we just kind of go out there and put out brochures. And after kicking it around, they said, you know, the data you've got and data we see out in the world could be put together to build a kind of predictive model to show you where you should go.
Sure.
And that was really kind of the, you know, watershed moment for them. Scales fell from their eyes, and they're like, oh, we didn't even think about predicting with data. Well, now we could do this and that and the other thing. So it's really that process of talking with people, getting to their real needs, and understanding what the data can do that helps you build the kind of AI solution that's really going to be useful for Duke.
Oh, that's good. And that's kind of like the reactive stuff, but you talk about the proactive stuff where finding problems can actually be harder than finding solutions. Talk a little bit about that.
Yeah, that's
stuff
right.
That's kind of unseen.
Yeah, so that's a great way of putting it, unseen. Yeah. I think a lot of times we see folks who come in and say, I want to go build a satellite imagery tool that's going to help find poachers. You may hear that from either side, NGOs.
Sure.
But you know, a lot of the time, that's not as easy as just getting a bunch of satellite imagery and running it, right? You know, and just getting into that because you don't know who's going to use it or how they're going to use it or if the data can even support it. So while a lot of people think donating their time involves just going to a nonprofit and saying, let me work on this project I think is cool or working with you, we actually find that finding the right problem to solve takes this kind of six-component process we talk about, where you have to find the right problem, you got to find the right data, you got to find the data scientists, you got to find the person who's going to act on it, the people who are going to fund it, and even subject matter experts who can say, hey, that poacher thing that you're building actually is a good thing, or oh, actually, if you tweaked it this way, it wouldn't just work for the World Wildlife Fund, but a lot of organizations. And so that's actually, I think, the trickiest part is not just saying, who's the nonprofit I'm going to work with, what do I solve? But saying, how do I really get all of those components, the data, the problem, the stakeholders, all around the table, so you can really design collaboratively to find the right thing. So when we say finding solutions or finding problems, it can be harder than finding the solutions. That's what we talk about, setting the right thing up.
And it's a good way of positioning it too. By the way, most people when they list six like parts to a solution, only get through like four, maybe four and a half. I don't have the data ahead of me, but I'm pretty sure that's about the right.
Yeah, yeah.
You talk a little bit about what is the single biggest kind of barrier for nonprofit organizations? Because it could be scale, it could be a lot of things, but what do you see?
Yeah, I think right now what we see is there's so much energy. People want to be able to use machine learning and AI, and they have really great interventions. I mean, some of these nonprofits are transforming the way that we think about everything from sanitation disposal to curing poverty. The challenge they have right now, I think, is one, resources. Just having the money to actually engage with data science and AI is incredibly expensive.
Right, and convincing someone that that's the best allocation of the money, right?
That's exactly right. You know, for people who haven't worked in nonprofits, you don't get money up front, right? People want to give you money to say, I want you to, you know, go save the whales, and I want to know where every dollar is going to go.
Right, because there's an accountability that you have as a nonprofit organization that you don't have as a corporation, because those stakeholders want to know, like, is 92% of this, is 94% of this, is 45% of this going to actionable stuff, right?
That's exactly right. So whereas a startup, they may say, hey, okay, here's some seed money to figure out some stuff with, it's very hard to get that in the nonprofit space. So to go to a funder,
yeah,
and say, hey, we need, you know, $500,000 to build an AI team, you know, you can get blank faces. Like, why, what is that going to do? Why would I give my money there? So that I think is one of the biggest challenges, and it's really a problem with the space and the way funding works in the nonprofit space. So that's why we offer our services pro bono, so that we can get over that barrier and you can just start working with, you know, expert Googlers right away.
Well, that's the double-edged causality of, like, being a nonprofit, is that people will want to work with you because it's cause-based,
right,
and it, you know, applies well to CSR, but they also want to know exactly what you're doing.
Yes. That's a big challenge.
You know, to close it out, because this is really concise advice, but what do you see the potential for nonprofits in the next 5 years kind of leveraging AI? Like, what do you think is actually achievable?
Yeah, I mean, I start to get a little optimistic over this. And
I like optimistic.
Oh, okay, great.
Like, we've talked and we've been rooted, but, like, give me your most, you know, optimistic future.
Well, it's in my mind, it's that we don't just look for, like, good values in data. We use AI for our own human values. That
sure.
Almost every field could be touched by AI in some way, whether it's, you know, again, transporting water more efficiently, or cracking down on diseases, or getting vaccination rates up.
Yeah.
It's everywhere. And really what I'd like to see, though, is that it not be on corporations alone to say, we have to give back to do this, and not be on nonprofits alone to say, we have to solve this problem, but that we actually start creating spaces where the two come together. Nonprofits who say, we know the space and innovation we need, but we don't have the resources, can sit across from corporations who say, we've got great human capital, we've got data that no one else has ever seen, we can provide some services.
Find those perfect mergers.
Yeah, so to me, that's my big kumbaya moment, is that we're all coming together to think about not just how can we make little drips and drops of improvements on these problems, but how can we really push together forward to use data for social impact.
But we're at a conference, so it's always good to end on a kumbaya moment.
Oh, good, good.
No,
I tend to always, so yeah.
Well, that's perfect. Well, so thanks so much, Jake.
Oh yeah, my pleasure. Thank you very much.
And follow us along at #AdobeTT. Tweet us. Thank you.